What is up, guys? Welcome back to Lego Rings with me, TapersCrazy. Where we left off, it appears that Gandalf would have got his ass owned by the old Saruman's, and these guys escape the Black Riders, and they're on the way round to Bree, the long way. I'm gonna practice one of this episode. It's gonna be a bit long, probably about 25-30 minutes, unless I get a shift on. But before every episode, I'm gonna do a bit of practice run, like just so I know what I'm doing, because you know, Lego games, if you don't know what you're doing, then chances are you're not going to get anywhere fast. So it kind of makes sense. It's one of the game series that needs you to do it, and this is introducing you to the crafting. The
fancy making me a mithril trowel to replace my tatty old one? For your trouble, I'll let you in on a secret to help you seek out other quests.
Yeah, and this is a mandatory quest which introduces you to the basic crafting of the game, how you make like mithril weapons and such. I just need to go in here. Get this. And it'll just walk us through it, but I'm gonna do it as quickly as possible. Just so. Okay. Select a design. Want this one. And then the blacksmith will start making it out of the bricks that I've made. And so all they're done to a levels, it's guaranteed that you're gonna have two bricks, but because I'm trying 100% it, then it should be easy. Like when I was in my practice garden, I didn't get 100%, so this is gonna be interesting, because it seems to be another marginal level on studs. I did die a couple of times, so it should be a bit easier. It's looking hopeful anyway. It was done really quickly, because this is not even part of the main storyline. This is just introducing you to things and such. Okay, come on, come on. Because the next level is Weathertop, where Frodo gets stabbed in the face, or the chest, which is close enough to the face, I suppose. Okay. And what is it going to do? Treasure trove, and we want the mithril trowel. Then the door opens, we can give this to that other guy. So it's a nice quick introduction to it. Like, if you didn't know what you were doing before, it would probably take you a little bit longer, but
oh, thank you so much.
You're welcome. I would have much preferred to have it myself. And I forgot to get that brick. I think I was supposed to press B to get it, but there you go.
Good evening, masters. What can I do?
We're friends of Gandalf the Grey. Can you tell him we've arrived?
Gandalf? Not seen him for 6 months. What do we do now?
Lovely. That's me in that club looking at your woman. What?
What's that?
Something for the road.
I'm getting one.
It's funny, because in the book, this was a lot more fleshed out. Like, the bartender's got a bit more impact on the storyline and such. Like, he owes Gandalf something, so that's why he helps out more. And like, all the men accuse Frodo of witchcraft, I think, because he disappeared. So, if you've seen the film and not read the book, I'd definitely suggest that you read the book or books. I'm like a quarter of the way through Two Towers and I stopped. But I think I'm gonna start again soon once I get some time off university and such. And this would have been better than the film. I think this is hilarious. This is just blocking me with your broom. Bit of a graphical glitch there, but we're pretty much where we started. We were just leaving the thing to get to the Weathertop, so. Here we have Aragorn, son of Arathorn, also known as Strider, one of the 9 Dúnedain of the Lost Kingdom of Numenor, or something like that. If I get it right, then you've got to like the video. If I've got it wrong, then go butthurt rage in the comments. And that's Weathertop. I'm glad they didn't make it a huge distance away, you know. It's like integral to the storyline, or the player's interest that you don't have to walk for 7,000 miles to get anywhere. You see, in my book, it was a couple of days away, Weathertop, but here it's just like right outside. Which is really nice. Oh god. Wait. Hobbits floating around and shit, and this is a save point, I think. Oh, it's a map stone. Because Bree's a really gigantic area, I've noticed. Yeah. I will eventually probably get around to doing free play, like I said before, but it will be as an extended series on a Friday or a Monday or something. So, like, if you want to watch it, you can go watch it, but I'm not... I won't expect it to be, like, a fully-fledged series, more like... I'm just doing this today, guys, it's a speedrun, like, but, you know. It's just the way I'm gonna do things.
We shall rest here tonight. Easy for you. And keep me close. I'm going to have a look around. Stay here.
And the best thing, there's some good things about this game, like it extends a tiny bit on the story, like this bit. It sort of makes a game out of the most, was it, the small parts of the story. Okay, let's do this. We need Lego wood, so we need to smash things up and such. All the studs, every single stud, I want all them studs. And again, I'm sacrificing pace for studs. If you've got a problem with that, then, I don't know, skip ahead or something. Let's do this. I do like this fishing element, it's kind of nice. I just like the responsive clicky sound, like, ba-doosh. Studs, 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 all them studs. Okay, onto this Sam. And it puts it in the frying pan and carries it around, which I think is really interesting. There we go, give him studs. So if you get a bit annoyed, like I've said before, that I'm smashing everything, then I really, really want to get adventure on everything, or true adventure on everything. Unless it's one of those impossible ones where I need, like, pretty much an like all the other characters before I do it. We'll see. We will see. Because I don't recall there being many studs in this level. I think I'm already doing a lot better on studs, because normally I just let them fly when I'm practicing. And I've left that wood there, which is a bit... Oops. Oop. Someone's fallen over in the bathroom, it would seem. That's funny. Serves them right. Yeah, let's do this. If this video is less than... is like 20 minutes on the dot or less, then... I'm gonna be very impressed. Okay, egg. Just put that on there. With my explorer around. I hope you don't need the carrot to get everything, because that's a bit silly. Everything, smash all the things. What's this? If I'm getting a vegetable or something? Of some kind. Tomato! Studs. See, a gold one's worth like 100, which is really good. Let's get all the gold ones. And I think we've got everything we need for a nice, for tomatoes, nice crispy bacon. Give me that gold stud. Give them gold studs. I'm after gold, blue more than gold, and gold more than silver, as it were. Probably missed something actually. There we go. And before I cook something, I'm gonna have a quick look. See if there's any breakable objects. Like, Frodo's face! Oh god, his face was actually breakable. There you go. And something new every day. I think that's everything. Okay, moving on. Unless you can break this with a frying pan of food. Sorry, I'm just getting paranoid because I know when I was practicing it's very marginal.
What are you doing?
Put it out, you fools! Yeah, it was a silly thing what the hobbits did, like light a fire and start shouting on the side.
Go!
Yes, but it's Sam with his frying pan. And I don't think this bit's timed at all. It makes it seem like it's really intense, but let's even continue. Sorry, didn't mean to hit you, Pippin. Can I hit this flower? No. Frodo can use his glowing file to light up dark areas. Give me Frodo then. Even though we've not got the Light of Elendil yet. Okay. So can I go in here? I'm gathering it means when I actually get it off Galadriel. So there must be something in there then. Probably a mini kit or something. All these golds falling off the face of the earth, don't like it. Oh come on game, don't drop them all off the floor like that, that's not fair. Gathering, I need some. Get on here. See, they never had to do this in the film. Otherwise, I'd have like closed that bridge or so the ring race couldn't get me, but there you go. Get them studs. Probably could have smashed it, but there you go. I think I'm already doing better than what I had in my practice run, so that's good. I like how I'm not focusing on the storyline, I'm focusing on kind of get all these studs. As I should be. Die, plant! Bye, Pippin. Bye, whoever else it was, Mary. Oh, God. Don't know that. It's over there. I think I went that way. We'll see. Give me that blue stud. I think blue stud's 1,000, which is really good. It's worth a lot. Set fire to this mountain! Everyone in Breeze will be like, what the fuck is going on? Just fires and shit. Definitely want to see if I can get up onto that grabby thing. What if I... No, I think I probably need a high jumping character like Legolas or Elrond to get up there. Give me that. Hoi, hoi. Give me them studs. Oops, Oz. Didn't mean it. Oh, that kills you if you touch it, so that's where I lost a lot of studs because I kept trying like an idiot. That down. Bridge. There we go. Up, 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 up. Anything down here? Can I jump off a mountain onto that thing? Clever design game, so you can't cheat it on there. That is very good validation of actually controlling what the player does. Okay, we're nearly at the top here, so we're about halfway there. Just hope I don't get killed by the wraiths a lot, otherwise that's going to screw me over big style. Sam. I can hear the ring wraiths. Okay, and I think it's the top up there. Which is... Grove a tree! God, Sam, the real tank of this game. It's like growing trees and everything. So, such a useful character. Can I hit this? No. Oh shit, no! Oh, that's bullshit. I did that last time as well. I just hope there's enough cushion for it, because this is very not lenient at all. I lost like a full blue stud. Gutted. If I don't get it, then I'll have to do it off screen, I suppose. I really want to do it all on screen. Come on. Ooh, that's cool. One, two, three, four. Come, like, just under halfway there. And I hope I don't get killed by the ring wraiths at all. Because this is nuts, this bit. Just in case his sword's not sharp enough. Owned. Owned. And this is where the split screen comes in. Because you need to work together to get things done here. Get as many studs as I can. And the ring wraiths can see me. Because they are drawn to the power of a ring and such. And when you're using it, it's on. There they are. Very clever what they've done. And the ring wraiths aren't overpowered, but do sort of hobble around slowly. Right, lads. Turn into Sam. I need to light a fire to scare away the Nazgul. Because they hate fire, apparently. Get all the studs. That's a purple stud, that's... Don't think I got that last time, actually, because this is... as close as I've ever been. Okay, quickly, this way. Push this off. I need Frodo to get that. Back, you devils! Okay, that'll do me. That Nazgul's getting a bit handy. Yeah, back, bitches. Missed. Okay. Come on, Frodo. To find your way to this one. There's nothing that's cool about. Oh, God. Oh, true adventure, that's fantastic. I'm doing immediately better than what I was doing. I think it's thanks to that purple one, which I think I missed, you know. That's just me. I'm a bit silly like that sometimes. Now I can just focus on getting my game done, because it's 20 minutes. I aim for 25. I want it to be under 30 for sure. Ooh. Just get studs in case I need a cushion, because I'm still unsure if like you lose studs, it takes the true adventure off you. Okay, come on. There we go. One more. But it's not a Frodo one. I think if I start lighting the fire, it can't touch me. Look at him just walking around like, "Ooh, I'm a ghost! Holy ghost! Ooh!" Screw you, fire. Here comes Aragorn. I like this bit, I enjoy this bit where they just set him on fire. It's really cool. Back, bitch. Okay. And this is where I kept dying all the time. Let's get all the bits of wood that we need. Soz lad, missed. Okay, up. There's one up here. And I can't help it that they're so quick, it's unbelievable. Need Sam to light it. Whoop! There we go. Missed! Missed again! You suck! Whoop. There's one more, I think Sam's got it. There we go! See, that's how quick I can get things done once I'm not trying for studs. Yeah. I just love the silliness of this game sometimes. Like, it's not as silly as all the other Lego games. Like, it does tend to stick to the seriousness of Lord of the Rings, but it still doesn't, like, look at that. As if I've got a stretcher. And we've unlocked Aragorn. I think that's it. Oh, I love 100%. It's just so cool, 100%. Like, complete 100. Perfect. And we'll get to the next hub, which I think will be with Arwen. Continue story. Arwen was really pretty in the films, though. Can't remember the actress that plays her, but still kind of hot. Just flail your hair about. Just that's how Lego character. Look at bloody Aragorn. And this is the next hub world, which is surprisingly daytime, and I wonder if the trolls are about, because that's where there was in the uncut film. This was where the trolls got killed by Bulbo. So, anyway, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Remember to like, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video where we will probably get to Rivendell, I presume. So, yeah, see you.